It takes place in the 80s.
They're in this lab doing crazy experiments.
And they opened up like a portal to the upside down, which connects to like our world.
This group of kids.
It's an adventure of them trying to save their friend, Will.
And he gets stuck in this parallel universe.
And they meet up with another child that was experimented on in a lab, since she can do crazy stuff with her mind.
The mom, kids, and police
try to confront these terrifying forces to try to get him back.
What's so interesting about this is that it borrowed certain concepts and certain themes that is out there in the realm of theoretical physics and quantum cosmology. So the concept of extra dimension, for example, is something that we have in theoretical physics. We deal with it. The concept of parallel universes. Same thing, but in this series, of course, all these concepts, they get interplayed. What you and I experience in this world, at this level, at the so-called macroscopic level, the concept of determinism is not there. A dimension and a universe is two different concepts, yeah? So a universe could have more than just the four macroscopic dimensions that we, as human beings, experience. In order to probe those extra dimensions, you need a huge amount of energy, infinite amount of energy. So that little girl, her name is 11, she's got that energy. So by her energy, she was able to probe the down world and open a gateway to that other world. The interesting thing about the series is that that downside world has the same timeline as the upside world. Yeah, and that's why I think there was probably a hint that maybe this is could be some other dimension. It couldn't be another universe, some other dimension, because they both share the same timeline.